position for you. Should it be legal for a business to refuse service to gays and lesbians because of religious beliefs? This is the substance of an amendment passed by the Arizona State Legislature, and the legislature says yes, and because of that, it's generated huge controversy. Supporters say the law just protects religious freedom. Those against it say it is a license to discriminate. Let's debate. Joining us from Washington, D.C. is Kelly Fedoruk. She's an attorney for the Alliance Defending Freedom, which was involved in drafting the amendment. Counselor, thank you for joining us.
Thank you, Steve, for having me. It's a pleasure to be here.
It's good to have you. You can call me Steve, but my name is Chris. It doesn't matter. Everybody calls me Steve. I don't know why. Let me ask you this, Counselor. The main proposition for why this is okay, in your opinion, is that it's an existing law and just an extension of a right that already exists. Explain.
Well, look, there's been a lot of lies and misinformation spread about this bill. And what this bill is not about denying people services. What this bill is advocating for is basic freedom, ensuring that everyone's human dignity is respected and that the government is not allowed to force or to coerce or compel anyone to violate their sincerely held beliefs or to go against their conscience. This is to basically keep the government from discriminating against people of faith.
Right. But fundamentally, what it allows, the mechanism, is to allow an individual business owner to refuse to do business with somebody on the basis of it offending their religious beliefs if they do conduct that business. So, for example, if I come to you and I say, hey, you sell flowers. I want you to sell flowers to me for my marriage to another man. You can say no, correct?
Well, there's a difference. Again, there's a basic difference between denying someone a cup of coffee or a piece of pizza or selling someone a pencil versus forcing someone to use their creative ability to create a message, to support an event, to participate or endorse an idea that goes against their fundamental beliefs. There's a big distinction. In America, the government should not force us to ever use our business, use our talents to go against our what we fundamentally believe in. There's a big difference, like I said, between selling a pencil and forcing someone to draw a mural that portrays this. I mean, think about, for example, we would not force a Muslim to participate in a Quran burning ceremony. We wouldn't ask a black photographer and force them to go take a picture of a KKK event. This is America. In America, we should be able to live freely and not be forced to support
Counselor,
or endorse ideas.
Counselor, tell me that you're not analogizing burning a Quran or the KKK with gay marriage. Do you really see those things as the same thing?
What I'm saying is that no one should be forced. I'm using that as an example. And this bill will not deny anyone any service. No one's going to be denied or kicked out of a restaurant or denied a cup of coffee or a piece of pizza. What this simply ensures is that everyone in the state of Arizona, these are common fundamental freedoms that are inherent in our country's history. And this bill simply protects those freedoms and allows people to live according to their faith without the government coming in and saying what you can and cannot believe.
It allows people to not do business with gays is what it allows. Your organization has a history of trying to hedge the ability to deal with gay marriage and gay rights in the country. All somebody has to do is get, you know, Google your organization. So let's just be open and honest about it. Why is dealing with gays or gay marriage tantamount to a substantial burden of someone's religion? Whose religion does that substantially burden?
Well, Chris, you're misunderstanding the point entirely. For example, in our Elaine photography case, it's a great example, is out of New Mexico.
Yes.
And Elaine is a wonderful young Christian photographer, and she started her photography company. And she is more than willing to take pictures of homosexuals. She will take passport pictures, portrait pictures, anything. What she will not do is use her creative art, her ability as a photographer, to go in and promote and endorse a wedding, an event that she doesn't agree with. There's a big difference between
being
forced to participate
in an event. But how is that a substantial burden? How is that a substantial burden? Let's say you're a Christian, right, which I'm sure most of the people that you're designing this law for would be. How is it a substantial burden to my Christianity to take photos of a gay marriage? If I'm against it, then I don't marry another man, right? Why is it a substantial burden?
It violates your religious freedom if the government comes in and forces you to go against, to act in contradiction to what you believe. And it doesn't just apply to Christians. Like I said, a Jewish baker, we couldn't ask a Jewish baker to go provide pork sandwiches for a wedding reception. That would go against his religious beliefs. And in America, the couple in Mexico, there are so many people willing to provide photography, to use their creative expression for that event. So why can't we just let everyone live and be free and respect and advocate for tolerance of all viewpoints, regardless of whether or not the government happens to agree with that viewpoint at any particular moment?
But aren't you arguing against tolerance? Because tolerance would be that as a business owner, I don't even know why you need the Arizona law at all, because if you don't want to do business with somebody, you can. For whatever reason, LGBT, the community in general, is not a protected class under the federal law, so it's not like race or religion where you can't discriminate. So you don't even need this law unless what you want to do is enforce intolerance, counselor. That's what it seems like you're doing to me, and it seems pretty obvious.
No, not at all. And for the record, I don't think most people have actually even read this bill. This bill for protecting religious freedom has been on the books in Arizona since 1999.
For religious organizations.
This bill simply closes loopholes to ensure, and it matches with the federal referendum. This bill simply ensures basic common freedoms for everyone, and it in no way, and I want to be really, really clear on this, it in no way would allow anyone to deny someone services. It would not allow them to kick them out of a restaurant or to deny them something. It simply won't force artists, regardless of what you are or anyone, to create or promote a message, to force them to be in a parade or to be in an event or endorse that with their business. It wouldn't allow them to do that because of the fundamental respect for religious freedom that we should be advancing.
If I come to your restaurant and ask you to cater my gay marriage, can you say no under the new law?
Under this bill, that no one would be able to deny anyone services. They couldn't say, no, I'm not going to give you a cup of coffee if you come
Cater my gay marriage? Can you cater my gay marriage?
There's a lot of examples, and it would depend on what that person's religious beliefs were. Like I said, the Jewish baker, we could not say he would have to be compelled to provide pork sandwiches for an event. I mean, it comes back down to religious beliefs.
That's because religion is a protected class, and LGBT is not a protected class. That's why you can't say to the Jewish baker that he doesn't provide pork sandwiches in your example there. But LGBT is not protected, so you are now designing a law that exploits that. Why don't you just own that proposition and say, yes, that's what my organization is about. We're trying to protect Christians who this kind of exclusionary belief, and that's what this law is about.
No, that's absolutely not what this law is about. This law is about protecting religious freedom and protecting the dignity of every single person and allowing, and no one, I can't understand why you would endorse the government and say, yes, the government can come into my life and it can compel me to create art or create something that violates what I sincerely believe. This is not a country where that's something that we've ever stood up for. That's if you're against discrimination, if you're against the government saying you can and can't do what you should and should not be penalized for in terms of going against your religious beliefs, you should be for this bill.
I understand your point. However, I don't understand the example of how the government is compelling anyone to do this under the law as it is right now. It's just that you're extending a right where it didn't exist before to have intolerance. But the government isn't telling anyone to do business with anybody, and the LGBT community is not a protected class. But we have to leave it there. I respect you coming on to make your arguments, counselor. This will not be the end of this law. I'm sure we'll see it other places. I hope you come back so we can continue the debate.
I would love that. Thank you so much.
All right. Thank you very much. What do you think? You understand it a little bit better now from both sides, probably, or if not, let me know. #NewDay.